I cannot tell you how many times I get asked how often you need to be posting on Instagram in order to grow your following on Instagram in 2020 for your business. Well, I wanna make sure that you guys stick around to the entire part of this video because I'm gonna teach you guys exactly how often you should be posting, when's the best time, and the difference between Instagram posting and Instagram stories and why you should be doing both in order to build engagement. All right, guys, welcome back. I'm your host, Jen Marilla, and thank you for being here today. If you're new, please subscribe and hit that subscribe button. Hit thumbs up if you're excited to learn how often you should be posting in order to grow your Instagram as a business and build engagement and grow your followers. I am Jen Marilla. If you've never heard of me before, you can check me out on Instagram. It's somewhere on the screen, and or you can check out my website. But I have taught over hundreds of online entrepreneurs build their online businesses using social media. Okay, so before we get into it today, I want to talk to you guys about something that's very important because we tend to get extremely overwhelmed and stressed. This is something my students come to me with all the time. They're like, Jen, I don't know how often I should be posting. I want to grow my engagement and I want to grow my following on Instagram in 2020. Like, how often do I need to be doing this, right? And usually that anxiety, which is something that I'm not about, like the minute I feel like I'm getting anxious about posting or stressed about posting, like, people, we've got bigger fish to fry. Like, that's the last thing we want to be worried about, right? So checking in on that first is the most important thing. And the reason I say that this is so important is because I teach my students that whatever you put out energetically is what you get back 10 times. So for example, if I'm feeling like I have all this anxiety about posting something, or I'm not sure about what I want to post, chances are that what I'm going to put out is what my audience is going to receive and what I'm going to get back. So what's likely going to happen is that my audience isn't going to even like the post that I'm posting, right? The reason I'm talking about making sure that mentally you don't have stress or anxiety when you're posting on Instagram is because of this, right? You can check out in this video here how I talk about how to overcome anxiety on social media. The reason I mention that is because we get overwhelmed and stressed because we know that we need to have consistency on social media, specifically on Instagram if we're trying to grow, and especially now in 2020, because that's the only way the algorithm grows. That means that you want to be practical about what you're actually consistently able to do. So there are two ways to grow your audience and build engagement on Instagram in 2020, and it's through an actual post and through consistently posting on stories, right? The important thing to ask yourself here, guys, is like, what is actually practical for you guys? I don't want you to be posting or saying you're going to be posting every day when in reality that is actually isn't feasible for you because maybe you have a 9 to 5, or maybe you're just really busy and that isn't practical. So do what is practical for you. If all you can post is 3 times a week, amazing, right? That's totally cool. Don't make it mean that you're not going to be successful or that you're not going to grow your Instagram because you're not posting every single day. I would rather have you post 3 times a week and have that quality of the content be amazing versus you posting every single day just to post because you think you need to post, right? A thing to really consider is the best time to post. Check out this video here where I actually dive into more of like what the best time is for your channel. I'm not gonna talk about that now because I did a video for it. So just check it out there. I dive into the best times to post for your channel, even if you have 0 followers and you're just starting, okay? When you're figuring out how often you should be posting, it is as consistent as you can make it. And that's literally what I tell my students all the time. Do what is practical for you. Because there are 2 ways to grow and build consistency on Instagram in 2020 now, through stories and posts, my recommendation is that if you can only post 3 times a week, like an actual post, then you be on stories as much as possible. So check out this video here where I actually dive into creative ideas for you to be able to post in stories 3 times a day, because that is my recommended advice, is that you post 3 times a day. That means you post in the morning, you post at lunch, and you post in the evening. And again, if you check out that video there, I definitely dive into what you could be talking about during those times. The most important thing about social media and how often you should be posting is that you have that consistency. If you can only post 2 times a week, but it's really quality content, and then Monday through Friday you're in your stories at least 3 times a day, you should see growth over time. Yes, if you do it more often than not, then chances are you will grow quicker than if you didn't. However, like I said before, I would rather you have quality content, because regardless of how often you post and how often you're on stories, if the quality of your content is not important to your audience, then it does not matter. You will not grow. You won't be good enough. The reason why I'm such an advocate for stories is because people on Instagram are actually on Instagram on stories. So it's a tool that if you're a business and you're not on stories, you are completely missing out, and you don't want to miss out.